Howdy, Nathan.
G'day, mate.
Feel like coming with me down to the sheriff's office?
Yeah.
Hands up for me. Come on in. All right. At this time, Nathan, I'm going to be placing you under arrest. With me downstairs. I'll read out your charges once we get down here. Okay. Nathan, for your involvement in the death of Mason James, today you're going to be charged with obstruction of justice and aiding and abetting. Do you have any questions, comments, or concerns with those two charges?
No questions.
All right. That is going to be an 80-day charge, or 80 days total. And a fine of $175.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead and give you 10 days of time served for your compliance during everything. Your total time will be 70 days served here in Strawberry, and your fine will be $175. Your release date will be 7:45 a.m. Eastern. There you go. Should have gone through for you. All right. Would you like anything while you're in here? Coffee, newspaper, anything like that?
No, I'm fine. Thank you.
Hey, if you need anything, I'll be here for the entirety of your sentence.
Okay. Yeah. Appreciate it.
It with the clerk.
I it was a mixture of shame and I've been on bed rest for about a week, so mostly shame.
I trusted you. I trusted you above anyone else.
Yeah.
They trusted you, Nathan. Every one of them trusted you. For what? Was it worth it? Was it worth it?
No. No. Had I known what I was getting into, no.
Had you known what you were getting into? What sort of bloody excuse is that?
I didn't know, Danny.
You didn't know when you were riding away? Didn't know when you sent the telegram? When didn't you know? Excuses. Poor man, excuses. How many lives do you think are going to go unsaved now because of your actions? How many calls are going to go unanswered because of your choices? For what? Vengeance. You didn't trust us to bring justice. You didn't trust me. Didn't touch the badge.
I went looking for answers, and all I got was more questions.
I trusted you.
Yeah.
I bled for you. I put on this badge. And I ask myself, am I enough? Can I be what they need me to be? And every day I ride home. Hell, I don't even have a home I ride home to now. But whenever I ride past that lodge, I smiled. I was proud. There's my family. You and Isla's actions betrayed us. Betrayed everything we worked for. I have questions about Sam Bass. Did he even think once before he pulled the trigger? Did he see a person? Did he feel the blood on his hands? What makes you think that your questions, Isla's questions, Hummingbird's questions, were worth more than any of ours? I don't even know how many rangers have passed before us. I don't even know how many are in the ground. But I wonder what they're thinking right now. He asked a question when we're recruits. Before we can even put on the badge. What is justice to you? Do you know what my answer used to be? Justice is fair. Justice is an even playing field. A place where we're all judged and treated equally. When man's wants and desires don't outweigh another. That is justice to you, Nathan.
Truth. Eventually, it always comes out.
I don't know what upsets me more. The fact that you did what you did. That you didn't come forward.
What do you think I did, Danny?
You knew a man's life was in danger. And you did nothing.
A telegram, dude.
You sent an anonymous telegram. Didn't even sign your own bloody name. Why?
Scared.
Scared of what?
It was just a scary situation. I've never been put in that situation before, and I was writing it quickly as well. They were already writing off before I could talk to the telegram clerk.
You know, when I found out how Andrew died, my mind raced. It was filled with all these horrible, dark thoughts, Nathan. They were terrifying. Some of them brought me pleasure, some of them rocked me to my core. All these things I wanted to happen. What I want to do. Thoughts that I never thought of before. What I'd do if I got my hands on that man. What I wanted to say. What I wanted to do. And it terrified me. And I was scared. I was so scared of what I would do if I ever crossed paths with him. But I'll never get that closure. I'll never know, Nathan. Do you know why? Because somebody took justice in their own hands. Trigger when they shouldn't have.
Yeah.
I never got to look that man in the eyes. I never got to see that man swing. I never got to ask him why. He's just gone. There's nothing now. What Hummingbird and Islet did. They robbed so many others. I hope it was worth it. We all worked so hard for that watch, and you too. So much work. So much blood and tears. Into that, to building this amazing family. I thought it was going to be different when Roy left. Do you know, law arranges. You think we can fix it?
Yeah. Yeah, I think we can. I've never not believed that we can't. There's a good bunch of rangers. Decent folk. me make sure of that.
I want to believe. I want to trust.
Yeah.
You know how humiliating it is to get pulled aside by a sheriff to say, hey, Danny. I just want to warn you. Something's going to happen with some of your rangers. And the first thought in my head was, no, you're wrong. You wouldn't do that. You'd stick my name on it. And then I read the report and it's... I rode out with the rangers the other day. And it felt amazing. But I realized how much they needed more help. Hell. We were standing there and somebody, one of them started firing behind me in Cobber. Almost hit us. Jesus. Thought, if Nathan was here, he'd pull them in line. You're not gonna be there now.
No, I don't deserve it.
I know you don't. You don't deserve it.
No.
And that hurts more. Just saying that. But it's true.
Because it is true.
It is true.
Deserve way better than what I'm able to give them and what they've been given. They deserve someone who's not broken and questioning everything around him every time he wakes up.
I remember having this conversation with Charles. And right, you were riding through tall trees. They were asking questions like they do, like they did. And you know what? What Charles said. We all have dark paths, Danny. We all are broken. Questionable dealings. Each and every one of us. That's why we're a family. That's why we're rangers. I think you need a bit of that to actually be a ranger, is what he said. So no, I don't agree with you. Right and wrong. And you did wrong. That's why you're in the cell. And why you don't have a poncho on your shoulders. You're better than this.
I know.
I stake my name on it.
That's why I came forward.
To hand yourself in.
Yeah.
Am I going to see you in a cell again?
No.
Look me in the eye when you say that. Am I going to see you in a cell again?
Never. No. I can't.
Take it.
No. No.
It's yours. I gave it to you because I believed in you. Because I trusted you. Because I still trust you. And I still believe in you. We all make mistakes. One really hurt.
Yeah.
Yeah. On that poncho is the blood of many other rangers. My blood is on there as well. Some things can't be washed away.
Yeah.
Scrubbed out. We can learn from them. I believe we can grow from them. I have to. Don't prove me wrong on this, please.
Y'all doing okay down here?
Yeah. Yeah, we're fine, Sam.
Okay. Either you need anything?
I think I'm done here. I need some air. Don't hurt me again, please. I haven't got much more I can hold on to.
You don't have to, you don't have to do that.
Do you think I'm gonna leave you here?
Mia. What I deserve.
Yeah, you do. Doesn't mean I'm gonna leave you. What are you gonna do?
For a bit. Not to run away, but to give myself the space I need, I guess, to sort my shit.
I talked to the sheriffs before all this. They agreed that I think it would be a good idea that if Ranger recruits are in need of ride-alongs, the seniors and above can take them for a ride-along when we're quiet to give them feedback, to try and help. Train some more rangers.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
I know it's probably a bit ironic coming from me, but there's more to us than our jobs, Nathan.
I never stop believing that, Danny. I know that.
What I mean is, you and Dax and you're still together, yeah?
Yeah, for now, yeah.
What do you mean for now?
Relationships got its ups and downs, so.
That they do. Yeah, that they do.
Yeah. He's not a ranger anymore.
Oh god, why?
I don't know, I've been too unwell to deal with it, so I have to talk to Buzz as well. Yeah, I don't know. I just got a telegram from Jackie the other day saying that Buzz fired him, so. But, I'm sure there's much more to it than that.
I get why people hate us sometimes. As deputies, as law. They just see this person that hammers down the law, the rules.
Yeah. How dare you make people feel accountable for their bad decisions? How, just so rude. So rude.
I know, right?
Mm-hmm. Just, it's like it's your job or something. Jeez.
I mean, I know myself. I have these amazing friends, family, and I never give them time. I feel like every time I try to, there's somebody screaming, help, help. Yeah. Hey, you a deputy, I need you. Mm. And then I feel like shit because I don't get to see my friends. But then I feel even worse if I don't help.
Yeah.
I almost hid in my bed, you know?
Oh, yeah.
After everything that happened, I wasn't sure if I could do my job.
Yeah.
And then I thought to myself, well, what the hell would you do, girl?
Yeah. I hear Rangers are hiring.
Time to make a poor Ranger now.
No. No way.
Hell. I couldn't even make it to a rock when a bear attacked me.
Shit. Oh, we've all been there. It's okay.
Do you ever wish you could go back in time?
All the fucking time, yeah.
Yeah, me too.
Except the thing I would change would mean that I'd never have come here to the crossing. So maybe that's a good thing we can't do.
I am. Yeah. I think about that a lot, actually.
Yeah.
I could turn back the time. Even just for a little bit, eh?
Yeah, just to see what would have happened. Yeah.
Do you think Jackson's the one?
No. No, I had my... I had my the one. I don't think you get insane that. It doesn't necessarily have to be only the one, you know.
You think we might get another one?
Yeah, I don't see why not.
Like to believe that, but I can't see that becoming true for me.
No, and you're probably not going to see it coming until it's right in front of your face. Yeah. It's a funny way of doing that.
It's true.
I sent Hart a telegram the other day, and pretty much just thanked him for opening my own heart back up to the idea of love, and that I hope he'd find the same.
Did I ever tell you I actually did my interview to become a deputy?
No. Or
no, I didn't cadet? Know that.
Yeah.
He was an absolute ass.
Yeah, I can see that.
He's actually one of the, I think he was the third lawman I met in the state. He was dressed like Santa.
Oh, God. Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. Okay.
Yeah, I can see that too. Oh, jeez. Yeah. Yep.
Oh, but like, I mean, like, just the coat. He had, like, Santa coat on with the big fur, red. Oh, and I just remember looking at this man thinking, this is a lawman.
When my fiance died, I thought that was it. That was it for me. I'd had my chance. That was it. I was sure of it. And, close my heart off for 5 years. So many missed opportunities, missed possibilities, but my heart wasn't ready for it. Your heart will let you know when you're ready. And you probably won't even realize it. Life is fleeting and cruel and hard. Share the journey with someone. It makes it a little bit more bearable.
That I've not told anyone else.
Yeah, of course.
I'm really scared, Nathan.
Of what?
I feel like I'm barely holding on.
Yeah.
Everyone keeps asking me how I'm doing. I'm terrified that if I lose someone else that I love, I couldn't do it. I'd lose myself. I couldn't come back. It scares me, terrifies me. Of what I'll become.
Yeah. I guess I guess you can find solace in knowing that you know that about yourself, though. Some people don't. loving is... is terrifying.
I wouldn't trade it for the world, though.
Exactly.
How are you feeling about your sentence?
It's an interesting question. It'd be weird if I said it didn't feel like it was long enough.
No. Let me sort your paperwork here.
Yeah.
I should feel a bit better now. Just give me a second, I'll just double check this paperwork.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, yeah, that's definitely gone all three right. Well, you're a free man now.
In one sense, yeah, I guess so.
Sorry about your fiance.
Yeah, he died doing what he loved with the badge in his hand. So yeah, I know.
Say to you something you used to always say to me and to everyone in the crossing, and I hope you take it on board. Be good to yourself.
Yeah, hold on.
Hey, partner.
Be sure to work on that.
Yeah, I'm still trying to work that one out as well.
Yeah. Sorry, Daddy.
Not as much as I am.
You got nothing to be sorry for.
I do. I failed you.
No. No, never.
I don't think. I know. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for the ages. And I know it's the same for a lot of people. Oh, I'm just gonna keep trying to do better. Or at least start trying, right? I'm gonna go hunting for a bit.
Yeah.
Okay. You stay safe, okay?
Yeah, I will. I'll let you know when I'm leaving, just so you know what's going on.
Thank you. I'll see you back.
Yeah, stay safe. Resolved.
Your Mr. Harden left town last night and took that whore with him.
Well, I'll be.
Sure, I'll hear about it from them.
I don't mind talking about it if you want.
Scared of the outcome?
How are you, mister?
No, I got charged, Buzz. It's all of it. All of it's resolved. got charged with obstruction of justice and aiding and abetting.
You think what happened with all that? He should still be in the Rangers.
No.
Hello.
No, I don't deserve to be.
So, yeah.
The trust that is gone, I know that. Do I think I'm deserving of another chance down the line. Yeah, but it's not right now. I've served one sentence, but I've still got another one to fix. So. My aim isn't to try and get back into the rages. It's to try and get back into the good graces of you and the people I hurt. If the opportunity to wear the poncho again comes up, then that'll be just a bonus.
Jackson stayed true to you the whole time.
What do you mean?
Did he do it all again? Exact same way?
Would I do it all? What do you mean? I don't understand.
Jackson told me he knew.
I knew it'd be colder.
This
no.
would.
He didn't know. What he thinks he knows, he doesn't. He knew I saw Mason. To keep it to himself. It was his bed to lie. If it came between choosing Jackson or the poncho.
Don't answer that.
Why not?
Should be Jackson.
No. I know it should be, but it's not. I know that's a horrible thing to say, but it's the truth.
Ended in his poncho. He had.
Okay, I was gonna ask about that because he told me that you fired him. So. You're
saying Mr. Owen beat the living hell out of told me to take it off him, so I did.
Right. Okay. Yeah, I thought it'd be something more like that. Yeah. Why did he? I've been sick, so I haven't had a chance to talk with him. I don't understand. I do understand, but I don't. The way he said it. Yeah.
All Probably be best you get it from him.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I respect that. Be will it be easier for you if I stand down over you firing me?
I need to talk with the state ranger first. Okay. I'm assuming they'll get all the information.
Yeah.
And they'll want information from me. Of the law, I'll do that.
Okay.
All this shouldn't have happened.
I agree.
Hurts the most, I think, for me. The fact that I don't think I'll be in your lives much no more. Sure does. Give yourself a good life.
Ain't the first time.
Yeah. You stay safe out there.
Keep Jackson around, T. Make sure you both need each other more than ever now. Good luck, Nathan.
Mister,